Hi guys, I'm Rahul and welcome back to, you know, my channel. So this video basically is about, I'm going to talk about sponge filters. Basically, these are the typical kind of sponge filters what you guys get in the market. I have previously made a video on how to open this entire thing up and how to clean it out and stuff like that. I'll leave the link on top. But today's topic is basically different. This is also a sponge filter which basically gets stuck to the glass of the aquarium. So this is basically very good when it comes to discus or keeping discus, and also mainly well breeding discus and all. This kind of filtration is really good because this gets stuck to the glass, so you know the base of the aquarium is pretty clear and it's easy to clean, and this entire thing can be completely dispandled. So both of these are sponge filters. It is not that only this is different and this is different. Both have got its own kind of advantages, but this. The problem with this is that there's a lot of kind of waste which gets stuck here, and this cannot be cleaned with a siphon. Our siphons generally don't reach this area. So what happens is we'll have to always open this up and to get it out. But of course this is a got much more bigger surface area and stuff depending on the size of sponge filter. This comes in different sizes. This one, the best part about this is that this can be just easily pulled out, and the sponge can just be pulled out and squeezed and put back, and this entire thing can be dismantled completely. I'll be doing that next. So this can be adjusted in different angles like this. You can make it look like a gun shooting. So anything can be done with this. So it is very interesting. So I picked this up long back, and when I started off the hobby back in the days, but recently I picked up about four from Pranav. Pranav basically is based out of Mumbai, and he deals with these kind of filters. So in case you guys need these kind of filters, please do contact him. I'll leave his number, his WhatsApp number and his number in this video's description. Please do contact him. He can tell you the costing, and he ships it across India. No problem at all. So I picked up four from him because I'm starting off for new aquariums for my breeding pairs and stuff. So this is pretty good when it comes to breeding setup. This kind of filtration is really cool. So basically I'm going to be unboxing what I received, the packing, and I'll be opening this up, and that's what this video is all about. So see you on the other side. So this is the package I received from Pranav from Mumbai. So I ordered basically four sponge filters from him. So let's unbox it or open it and check how it is. Like I said earlier in the video about the advantages of this type of filtration. So I'll basically show you what all can be done with it with regards to the cleaning part and all that. It's been packed pretty well. Here it is. So this is how it looks, and so that's about it. So this is how it looks. So it's got these two suction which sticks onto the glass, and this can be extended up to pretty good heights. This also can be removed. Anyway, I'll just be showing that how that's done. Pretty neat.
So sponge filter basically does both the two types of filtration. One is mechanical and also does biological. So mechanical, basically this sponge outer kind of absorbs all kind of waste what is there, and because it's a sponge, so it also forms a colony for the beneficial bacteria. So it does both the things. So this basically, this type of filter, like I said earlier, it gets this vacuum caps, it gets stuck to the glass, so the bottom of your aquarium is completely clear. The size of this is about, this can be extended, so the size of this is about 1 feet. As you can see, it's about 1 feet, and this can be adjusted in all sides and shape. This is where the inlet pipe has to go in. So sponge filters basically don't come with any kind of motor or something, so you need an air pump for it. So the air pump inlet has to be connected here, so the air passes through this and goes through both these sections. So it's got these holes where the air comes out. So that's how this whole filtration process works. So another advantage of this is, once this is fixed to the basic aquarium, so typical the other kind of filter, you know, sponge filter, you need to pull out the entire assembly to clean it. But with this case, you just have to, you know, pull out only these two sponges. And in case you're doing some kind of medication or something where you don't need the sponge, just remove the sponge and leave it here. And you can leave it in the tank, and this will just work as a basic kind of a aeration kind of a bubbler. Also, one more thing with this kind of sponge filter is this because it can be adjusted to the height. So this can be kept to the surface of the water. I mean the water level in your tank, so it displaces your, so it creates a small kind of a wave inside your aquarium. So this can be adjusted to the top level of your aquarium water level on top. So that's a good thing about this. And for cleaning this entire thing, like I said, can be opened out completely. So all of it will come out. So every portion of it can be dismantled. Even this thing comes off. And it's pretty easy to put it back. It's not very difficult, so it's all very simple. So the whole assembly can be pulled out, as you can see. So it's not very difficult. So that's about it. It hardly takes less than a minute to put it all back. So yeah, like I was saying, so when you're doing medication and all, you just have to remove these two spawns, so this still forms like an aeration. Okay, so this size is, like I said, is about 1 feet. This is ideal for up to 2.5 to 3 feet tank. You need only one of these. If it's like a 4 feet or a 5 feet tank, you might need two of these. So for a small tank, this is pretty decent. So about 3 feet, this one filter will handle quite a lot of it. And yeah, one more major reason I was telling, even I mentioned this earlier also, is the easiness to clean and maintain. This is much easier than the other regular kind of sponge filters. It's not commonly available everywhere, this type. So whenever you will have to look for it. But anyway, I've got Pranav nowadays, who is based in Bombay. I mentioned this earlier, so you can get in touch with him. I'll leave the details in the description. Okay. So hope you guys like it, and if you guys like it, you can definitely pick it up from him. It's pretty neat. So this is the sponge filter, which like I was saying, if you keep it to the top level, so it kind of displaces the top surface of the water. And this is pretty dirty. I have not cleaned it in some time, just for this video, so you can see how much this thing basically absorbs. So like I said, in the bottom it doesn't disturb, so it's pretty good. Stays like a neat thing. So I've kept this in my partition for my breeding tank. Yeah, so that was the whole idea of these kind of things. So it gets stuck to the glass. Yeah, it's pretty dirty. I need to clean it. But yeah, of course, I didn't clean it because I wanted to show the video what this can do. So this is basically absorbed quite a lot from this. Is I think about 10 to 15 days since I've cleaned it. So that's why it has picked up quite a lot of it. So this is what this basically this sponge filter can do.
So hope you guys like this video. If you did, give us a big thumbs up, like and share our videos, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, and please don't forget to hit the bell icon, because if you don't hit the bell icon, you guys will never know when we post videos. So I regularly make new videos on Friday, and I'm planning to convert videos in Tamil, Malayalam and Hindi. Those videos are all coming out soon. So stay tuned, and like I always say, this hobby is really fun if you do it the right way. Cheers guys, love you all, bye bye.